The body sealer material comes on a stand. You have your heat wand attached to a chain. You have a box cutter to cut the material. You're also given a clamp to keep the material together as you seal the edges. And then finally, you have a roll of the material here. To start your heat wand, you're going to go ahead and plug it in and then flip the switch to high. After that, you want to set your heat wand in a safe place so that it can heat up. We need to prepare our remains for body sealing. We're going to do that by wrapping the body in either a sheet or plastic shroud, very gently, trying not to aerosolize anything. Whether or not you remove tubes or other IVs is really a function of your situation. Once we have the remains wrapped, we're going to go ahead and tape them closed so that they are contained for the rest of our processing. The body sealer material can be unrolled from the dispenser to the length that you need. And then we simply cut the amount of material that is required. If the material is not wide enough to fully cover your remains, it is possible to go ahead and double the material by sealing the edges. Once the bioseal material is cut, we need to roll our patient onto it. The bioseal material has a sealed edge and an edge that opens up like a book. You can see inside is more of a foil-lined material. So what we're going to do is roll the material up slightly and roll our patient onto the bioseal material. Once our patient is in place, we'll go ahead and fold the top over, and it'll be ready for sealing. We're going to create a double seal, and we're going to do that all the way around our package. So we'll go ahead and go deep with our first seal, and then a little further out with the second. We're going to do that, like I said, systematically all the way around our package. The clamp that you're given is very helpful to keep the edges of the material together as you are doing your systematic sealing. So our first clamping will be as deep as we can go. And then the second one will be a little further down. And you can see once you've sealed it, you get obvious bumps in it, as well as a color change. We can reinforce the corner with a diagonal seal. If the remains are a biohazard, we treat them a little bit differently. We would go ahead and cut the extra flap off of the external seal, removing these extra flaps, and then go ahead and wipe down the entire external surface of the bioseal material to make sure that it's clean with bleach wipes or antimicrobial wipes. After this is done systematically, it's handed off to the team who will go ahead and take our remains into storage. Once the remains are prepared, we need to go ahead and label the container. So we're going to use the patient's name, their date of birth, the date and time of their death, as well as their med record number if it applies. We also want to label the bag as a biohazard. The body sealer expands our resources for dealing with mass fatality events and pandemics. As you can see, it's fairly easy to use.